Glory be to Jesus Christ. Welcome to St. Michael's this morning as we share in the diocesan wide prayer to the Holy Mother of God through the live broadcasting of the 11 services to the Mother of God, which is continuing from 8 a.m. this morning to 8 p.m. this evening. We're happy that you're here in St. Michael's to join us. We'll begin at 10 o'clock. We ask you to please pray with us, the Lord of Mercies, the prayers that you know, and of course, the hymn, the Mary, Mother of God, pray for us.
Infirmities for your name's sake.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, always and ever and forever.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever and forever. Amen.
Come, let us adore God, our King.
Come, let us adore Christ, our King and our God.
Come, let us adore and bow down to Christ himself, our King and our God.
Hear my prayer, O Lord. Give ear to my supplication. In your faithfulness, answer me, and in your righteousness.
Do not enter into judgment with your servant, for your sight no one living is righteous. For the enemy is persecuted by his soul, he is crushed by life to the ground, he is made to dwell in darkness like those who have long been dead.
My spirit is overwhelmed within me, my heart within me is distressed. I remember the days of old, I meditate on all thy works, I muse on the work of your hand.
I spread my hands to you, my soul longs for you like a thirsty land. Ask me, speak of you, O Lord, my spirit fails.
Hide your face from me, lest I be like those who go down into the pit. Cause me to hear your loving kindness in the morning, for in you do I trust. Cause me to know the way in which I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you.
Deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies, and I take shelter. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your spirit is good.
In the land of the uprightness, revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake.
For your righteousness' sake, bring my soul out of trouble, and your mercy cut off my enemies. Destroy all those who afflict my soul.
Sinful and humble, thou mercy hasten to the mother.
She entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. And it happened when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Then she spoke with a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women. Blessed the fruit of your womb. But why is this granted to me? The mother of my Lord should come to me. For indeed, as soon as the voice of your greeting sounded in my ear, the babe leaped in my womb for joy. Blessed is she who believed there will be fulfillment of those things which were told her from the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For as regard to the lowly state of his maidservant, behold, henceforth all generations shall call me blessed. For he was mighty, has done great things to me, and holy is his name. His mercy on those who fear him from generation to generation. He shone strength with his arm, he has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He's put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted the lowly. He's filled the hungry with things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, in remembrance of his mercy, he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his seed forever." And Mary remained with her about 3 months, and she returned to her own home.
Joy of the sorrowful, consolation of the afflicted, Christ is among us. It has been a joy to be part of the celebration of prayers today for the afflicted throughout our community and throughout the world. As we offer these prayers to the Holy Mother of God, we beseech your intercession and her blessings through her Son for all who are suffering, all who come to their assistance, all who find themselves in these days of trouble. In this beautiful Moleben service, we have wonderful hymns that are part of the tradition of our people. There are many songs that I think are composed that could be seen in the same light of prayer to the Mother of God. Well, early this morning, before dawn, I was thinking of being in Camp Nazareth a few years ago during a clergy retreat right after Pascha. And our Bishop Metropolitan Gregory had said to his priest the evening before, "Get up before dawn. Listen to the 20 birds of spring singing before the crack of dawn." And I opened the window and I listened. I'm not in camp, but I heard at least 10 birds singing. And while I heard them singing, I was thinking of these hymns to the Mother of God, and suddenly in my mind's eye came lyrics of another kind of song. More than 50 years ago and sung by the Beatles. Remember that? Let It Be. Thought to myself, is this some link to the prayers to Mary in the modern age even here? Maybe God listened to this song during these days of quarantine and pondered his words with the eyes of faith. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. In my hours of darkness, she's standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer. Let it be. When my night is cloudy, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. But the blessing of the Lord, through his grace and love for mankind, be with you now and ever and forever. Glory be to you, Christ God, our hope. Glory be to you.
On us and save us. He is gracious and he is the lover of man.